So now we need to replace that shed. You can see what the scene behind me, that it's an old shed. It's got holes in the roof, it's got a window missing in the side, it's not secure, so it's damp. So I'm going to demolish that one today, and then you can see that, and then we'll prepare the base for a new shed. We're going to order a metal shed instead of a wooden one, so it's a little bit more secure, a little bit more long-lasting, things like that. It's slightly bigger, so we need to get the base a little bit bigger, so we'll prepare the base, and then we'll erect the shed, and then we can put all that equipment into the shed. So it's just a simple little job, hopefully, and you can see me now how I'm going to demolish it. So we've taken down the shed, got rid of the main part of the shed. We're keeping the base because we might use that as the floor for the metal shed. We've decided on the shed we're going to buy. It's going to be a 10 foot by 13 feet, which is quite a wide shed, but as we haven't got a garage yet, we're going to need that sort of space to put all the stuff in. The base, as you can see, it's not flat at all. So I'm going to lift all these patio slabs up. The base roughly, or the shed itself, is roughly where we've put these bamboo canes. So it's about nearly 18 inches wider than what the base is at the moment. I'll go another 6 inches on the base, just to make sure we got plenty to sit the shed down on. So now you can see me lifting up these. A bit boring, I know, but okay, just have a look. Okay, we got rid of the old shed, and now I'm extending the base to enough for the new larger size shed, and I'm going beyond the width and the depth of that shed, length of that shed, to by about 30 centimetres, and that'll give us a nice big base for it to sit on. Going down to a depth of about 3 to 4 inches, or 75 to 100 mil. And I'll do that all the way around. I'm leaving the existing base down, and I'll probably go on top of that when I put the sculpings in sand down. And I'll go deeper down there, things like that. And the base that I've bought, as you can see, I've had a delivery over here. I've had a bulk bag from, well, all of this has been delivered by Wix's. So there's a large bulk bag of what they call type 1, MOT type 1, which is like a gravel to dusty stuff. And I've had a bulk bag of building sand. I'm going to add to the patio stones that I brought up. There's 25 18 inch square patio stones there. I've also got some aerated blocks for a door I want to block up later. And those patio stones will add to those patio stones to complete the base. That's the plan. Okay, we've done the trench around the outside of the original base. It's got a bit hot, change the t-shirt. We have a little look. So I've gone about 3 to 4 inches down. This is the original base. And what I'm going to do now, I've just put a small bit of shuttering up there, because I think we're going to need to come up higher than the original base. You're going to get dizzy now, aren't you? And what I'm going to put down as well is this damp-proof membrane. It's just a membrane you should put down. Some people don't, some people do. I'm going to, and it'll stop any weeds and everything else coming up. Right, so we've put the membrane over the top. Never had quite really enough to do the whole size of that, because it's only 3 meters by 4 meters. So we've added to the bags. It doesn't really matter. I know the original base had a membrane underneath it, so I'm only doubling up on that. So now that's down, we're going to mix up some of the sculpings and the sand and fill it in. What I'm going to do is, I've never done this before, but I'm just going to do a dry mix. I'm going to do probably 4 shovels of that stuff, 2 shovels of that stuff, and a half a shovel of cement. I'm going to do it dry, put it down dry, because it's only a base, it's not a concrete really, so we'll just see how this, how that works. We've been mixing up some of the sculpings and the sand and a little bit of cement, and we've put it down like that. Can you see that? So we've covered the whole area now. It's obviously with this type 1 base layer has got some large stones in it, which I'm not too sure about, but still. And now I'm going to start laying some sand and a bit of cement over the top. With that we can get it a lot more accurately flat all over. So I don't know if I got enough sand, but it might be enough. I've certainly used all of the bulk bag for that area, but we're getting there. I've got to this stage of the base now where I've got it nice and square and flat. Just a slight runoff at the moment, but, and also I want it to be a bit higher than where it is at the moment. I want the front of the shed to come up a few more inches in that, or a couple more inches in that, before I put the slabs down, before I put the patio slabs down. We've got the width and we've got the length we need. So now I'm expecting another delivery of sharp sand and some cement, and then I'll just do a covering over that, get it exactly flat as I want it, and then we'll put the slabs down. Okay, what we've done is, as you can see, made it as flat as we can, just given an ideal of where the patio slabs need to be, and now we're mixing some sand and cement to start putting them down. We've done a few more patio slabs down. We're calling it a day for now. We've done a line, if you can see, I've done a line along the front of it and a line along the edge of it. We're going to put the old patio stones that was from the original base in the middle, so we don't see that when the shed is actually down, all we'll see on the edge will be the new patio stones. I've run a line, let me just show you. I've run a line, a string line, just to keep it straight that way, and a string line that way. We've just done 5 dabs of cement or mortar. We mixed up 4 shovels of cement, sorry, 4 shovels of sand to 1 shovel of cement, mixed it up with some water, and put 4-5 dabs on each tile. We flattened it all down, like I said earlier, and we're going to carry on building all of that down until we're finished. That's it. Looks quite good at the back, so I'm not going to do too much. It's a bit level. I'm not really looking for a bubble, although the bubble's pretty good. So I finished the patio slabs now, and they're down. You can see the ones in the middle are from the old shed, and I've bought some new same size patio slabs to go around the outside, so that once the shed is on there, all you'll see is the new shed patio slabs around the outside of the shed. I've jointed it all in very roughly. It's all nice and solid now, fairly flat, not as flat as it could be, but it's flat enough. I've had the YardMaster shed delivered today, and I've got 2 others, I'll show you that, 2 other boxes in there, so I'm opening the basin there. I'm not too sure what is in each of the boxes, but we'll have a look together. So this is the other 2 boxes here, well 3 boxes actually, there's one underneath there.
Lots and lots of metal brackets. So I'll take these indoors now.
Well, this is the instructions. Please. Wow. We started the shed. A little bit tricky, I'm glad I had help to do it. So we put the corners on. The braces around the middle. Got the threshold bar on there. Doors, joins. All looking quite good. So, we've got so far, we've got all the sides on, we've got the braces across the roof, and it's looking like a shed now. So we're getting there. Just need to put the roof on and the door is on. But you can see, it's not as tall as I would like, but certainly get the stuff in here. So the braces are all on. Next step, the roof. Right, before we put the roof on, what we've decided is the shed's a nice big size in terms of area, but as you can see, it's too short. It's just much too short. We've always banged our head on it or whatever. I'm going to have to duck under it like that. So I think it's too short. So what I've decided to do is I'm going to put it on concrete blocks, upright concrete blocks, so it'll be about 9 inches higher. So I'm going to lay a best, but the trouble is when you do that, the threshold strip that goes around across there, it will be up in the air if you let raise up. So what I'm going to do, rightly or wrongly, is I've taken the threshold off down there. I'm going to cut the threshold because you still need the channel to shut the doors, and I'm going to extend the doors down with some extra galvanized sheet, hopefully. So then we'll raise the shed, but keep the threshold down there because, like I say, the channel in the bottom strip needs to be there to guide the doors. So the theory is going to be sound because we have it much higher, we've still got the door retention. Let's hope it works. Well, we got a bit of an incident today. It's very, very windy. I hadn't put the roof on because I want to build up the bottom of the base with breeze blocks. And today is very windy. And it's moved the whole of the shed over. We've buckled it. I'm trying to support it. Trying to support it because we're going out now. But I've buckled the shed here. It's buckled in a couple of places down there. In the moment, I'm keeping it up against the existing fence. Oh goodness! But anyway. So, hopefully, when the winds die down, and on another day, I'll set it right. What I've done is I've positioned the shed where it's going to be, and I've got some China graph pencils, and I've marked where the shed's going to be. So I'm going to use that marking, and I'm going to cement some breeze blocks down, and then I'll get some extra help to lift the shed onto the new height. So it's not going straight forward, but we're going to get there. Right, finished the block laying, so that's going to give us some elevation to put the shed on and give us a bit more height, because the door is much, much too low. So what I've done is I've actually put some blocks in six places, laid flat, which jut out in those six places. Mainly what I'm going to do is use those as a point where I can bolt the shed down. I've created the 1.2 meter width, so that we got the door nicely set. So hopefully now I need somebody to help me lift the shed up and onto the blocks. Right, we've got the shed on the blocks, you can see. I'm going to start putting the roof on now. What I've done as well is I've screwed it into the blocks. There. So now I'm going to start putting the roof on. Now, I've looked at the instructions loads of times, and you really need to map out exactly how it's, and I don't even know if I got that right yet. But I've started putting one on, so I'm going to add to that now and see if we can get the roof on today. As you can see, we've got 3/4 of the roof on now. It's been quite tricky. Couldn't do anything yesterday because it was raining, but going to carry on and try and finish it tonight. You've got to be a bit careful on how you plan each panel going onto the roof. There's a translucent one there. They have different sizes. Mainly, the main ones in the middle are the same, but the four corner ones are different sizes. Because on the four corners, we have this overlapping one, like overlapping to the edge of it. So you need those in the right positions. But they're all numbered, so there shouldn't be a problem. And then in here, you can see we've got most of them in. We've got light coming in from the translucent ones there. They're screwed, all screwed into the top there. You have a little look on the top. Yeah, so I've started doing the final pieces. I'm putting the ridge panels on there now. It's a little bit awkward in as much that the ridge panels are a different size to the panels that are on the roof. Consequently, they're longer or shorter. So when you want to screw one of these down into it, it could be that it's underneath there, and you think, well, I need to get that on, screwed down, before that. So what you need to do is, before you put that one on, screw the one down in underneath there into the panel, and then fold back this one before you screw all the rest in. Fold that back and then reach across and screw the ridge panels on. Then let this drop back and then screw them in. I've found in a few places, not many, where it doesn't match up with one of these holes here. Make sure it's in focus. One of these holes here. And I've had to use a small drill bit, because it's only a few millimetres out, but I've had to use another small drill bit to screw down through. And then, but that's not a problem. They seem to be all fitting nicely anyway. So I'm going to put the rest of them on now, and then we'll concentrate on the door. Right, I'm assembling the doors inside the house. Got to be a bit careful when you put these strips on and screw them in. The screws that come through are really, really sharp, so you need to put some covers over that. And the handles are screwed in by some bolts in there. So I put the top one on there. I put the middle one on there. I'm leaving the bottom one because I'm going to extend the doors. So I don't really know exactly how much I need to extend the doors until we hang the doors. But we've got two door panels, and they're fairly easy to, you know, the strength is on these three bracing struts across. But like I said, I'd probably put one on there, but then I'll put another one, I'll buy another one and put a sheet of metal along the bottom. Right, we've finished the roof completely now. We'll finish the whole shed really, apart from the doors. So all the panels are on, put that on the top, you can see all the panels are on. All screwed down nicely. Nice big bit of headroom here, but much better than ridiculously short. Nice big space, looking good. Just to put the doors on now. Apparently the doors get hung on these two sliders here. So I'll go and find out how that is. Right, my next step is to extend the bottom of the doors. So they obviously drops down to the floor, so we got secure doors because the gaps, because we've raised this now, the gap at the bottom of the doors needs filling in. What I've bought is I've got two sheets of metal, stainless, and I bought three pieces of aluminium square. These are the three pieces of 15 millimeter box form aluminium. I'm going to cut these up. I'm going to give them strength to strengthen up the pieces of wood that I'm going to be putting on there. Also, I'm going to use them as a guide to the runners. A guide to the runners, so when they're on the door, they'll be able to stay within the guide of this underneath here. When this threshold strip was delivered, the idea is to drive over it or to roll everything over it, but I think it's a bit too flimsy. I think it'll crush. So what I've done is I've cut a piece of wood so that will give it some strength there. I've increased the height by adding this stainless steel plates both sides of here. I took the channel from its original path up here down to the floor below by where the blocks need to be, so that's good. Two of these eye plates here so that I can use a padlock across there for security. Doors come open, and they're a decent width for getting anything in there really. So that's the shed complete. I'm happy with it. I'm going to get lots of stuff that I would have normally had in a garage into the shed there, and that one is complete.